sound very well.
I'm not. I think I'm dying.
Then I hope you find peace.
I don't know too much about peace.
Yeah.
Passing you.
Watch out.
Follow me.
So where are we going?
I want to show you a site up in the mountains that's long been sacred to me. A place for reflection and healing. What is this news, Captain Monroe?
Yes, sir. As I mentioned, I did speak again with the mayor and the Bureau of Indian Affairs in Saint-Denis at length. But regrettably, it appears the oil company has already received approval to move forward with drilling on the reservation's land.
I suppose this much. So what does that mean for us now?
I'm not sure just yet. I didn't get the impression anything would be happening for a few months. I'm very sorry, sir. I did everything I could.
I know, Captain.
And I assure you I will continue to do as much as I can. Mr. Morgan, would you have time to help me at all? I would rather certain actions were taken by friends outside the tribe.
Sure, I can help.
That's good news. Thank you. Come meet me on the reservation whenever you can. Even just a couple hours of your time. Anyway, gentlemen, I won't take up any more of your time. I'll see you both soon.
Sure.
Thank you, Captain.
Enjoy the ride.
We'll continue on this way. I'm going to look for some herbs to give you. Easy. See the wolves over there feasting on that horse? Brutality and beauty are both all around us. Yet so often we're unable to see past our own grievances. This is what I try to teach my son.
Yeah!
Whoa!
Yeah! Go on, get out of here!
Good. There was no need to harm them.
Yeah.
We can talk if you want, Mr. Morgan. But don't feel like you have to. It's a beautiful ride ahead if you need some time to think.
So, we don't know each other too well, but I wanted to speak to you about your son. I was there on the raid to steal back those horses, and, well, you know something of Dutch, I think.
Yes, a little. Mostly from your friend Charles.
I don't know why Dutch is getting involved in your situation, and this ain't easy to say, but I just don't trust that he's got your son's best interests at heart.
So what can we do?
I don't rightly know.
Sorry, hold up a moment. That'll have to wait. Some of the plants I need will be growing down here. You to see this place. This is what I was looking for. English mace. Let's continue on. So, what were you talking about before?
I don't rightly know. Charles and I just thought you should be aware.
We can talk if you want, Mr. Morgan. But don't feel like you have to. It's a beautiful ride ahead if you need some time to think.
So, we don't know each other too well, but I wanted to speak to you about your son. I was there on the raid to steal back those horses, and, well, you know some...
Sorry, hold up a moment. That'll have to wait. Some of the plants I need will be growing down here. Let's continue on.
So, yeah, well, you know something of Dutch, I think.
Yes, a little. Mostly from your friend Charles.
I don't know why Dutch is getting involved in your situation, and this ain't easy to say, but...
It's not that way.
You were saying before...
I just don't trust that he's got your son's best interests at heart.
So what can we do?
I don't rightly know. Charles and I just thought you should be aware. Maybe there's a way to stop things from getting any more out of control.
Thank you, Mr. Morgan. Let me give this some thought. Be careful. There are some steep turns up ahead, but the views are beautiful from up here.
Things that bad on a reservation?
Yes. This conflict with Colonel Favors and his regiment at Fort Wallace continues to worsen. Many of the elders are sick, and the young feel that any compromise is an admittance of defeat.
Well, we ain't done much to calm the situation.
But I have to continue to seek to Wait, stop here. I want to pick some ginseng. We can talk more about this later. This will combine well. Wait there. I'll put these in your saddlebag. Mix these together. It tastes awful, but it'll help to keep your strength up. All right, let's go. It's not much further now.
Anyway, you were saying...
But I have to continue to seek to resolve matters through peaceful negotiation.
people are lucky to have you.
I'm not so sure about that.
I appreciate the herbs, but I think it's gonna take more than that. I saw a doctor, and he says I'm in a pretty bad way.
I'm sorry to hear that.
This situation we're in, me, Dutch, and the others, I don't know how long I got, but some of them, they still got a chance to have a life. I just think it, if I could give them that, then maybe this ain't all for nothing.
I think there's much you can still do, Mr. Morgan. It's just up ahead.
What's happened?
No!
It can't be.
No! They destroyed everything!
Find the Chinupa.
Who would do this?
Someone who wanted to enrage you.
Help me look around, please. The Chinupa is gone.
Of course. What is it?
A ceremonial pipe. There must be some clues to what happened here. It's ruined.
There's some logs here they must have used as kindling. Looks like they was doing some drinking.
Please, come look at this.
An empty bottle of whiskey.
If they drank all that, they couldn't have gotten too far.
Yeah, well, still no sign of the Chinupa. There they are. These brave men. Some of Colonel Favor's men. They must have been the ones who did this.
Are you surprised this happened?
Not at all. But I hope we were past this.
Well, you got land they want. Land with oil.
They moved us here.
They've taken everything we had. I signed 3 treaties myself, and they've broken each one. No, they've taken the last hope. Now my people are going to want a war. A war they can't win.
Not if I get it back.
Get it back?
Yeah, I'm gonna go in, get your chin up, and no one will be any the wiser.
Would you do that?
Well, you can't go. They know why you'd come.
I don't have any money.
Nah, I don't need your money.
Please see if they have our sacred items. But try not to hurt anyone.
I'll try to ensure that they never even know I'm there, but actions don't always go the way you plan.
You said you were going to look for the Chinoompa. If you could do this for me, I would very much appreciate it.
France near Canada then?
No. France is near. It's near France. Well, it's in France. Indians is from here.
Where are you from?
Me? I'm Polish. You know why?
I think I saw someone.
Oh!
Here. I got your things, I think.
Yes. Thank you.
I'm very sorry about this.
Even sacred things are only things. People, the heart, matter more. Was anyone hurt?
No one was killed.
Well done. Well done. I wish my son knew such restraint. My people owe you a great debt, and I'm giving you very little. But please, take this. We believe it to be sacred.
Thank you.
Thank you. Take those herbs I gave you, please. And most of all, I hope you can find peace within yourself.
He's a man who, not so long ago, I would have found weak and pathetic. Now I see as wise and thoughtful and sensible. I would love to help him, or at least stop Dutch pushing his son to do something real stupid. ain't personal, mister.
Well, maybe another time. You take care of that bee, you pitiful horse of yours.
Yep.
Captain Monroe.
Of course.
Chief's gone out trying to find medications. It's quite a business.
Yes. Thought we were through with all of this.
Well, we are, mostly. Colonel Favors seems to think the natives have broken some promise they never made, and apparently he's punishing them by withholding vaccines sent down by the federal government.
Really?
I was supposed to oversee the administration of vaccines. Now I hear the wagon's been diverted.
Why would he do such a thing?
To be honest, I truly don't know. They say he didn't have a very good war, so maybe he's trying to start another one.
Is that what you think?
I'm trying to find out, and he knows I'm trying to find out. He'd love to provoke me almost as much as he'd love to provoke these poor bastards.
Meaning?
Meaning that despite the fact that I think he's a horse's ass, he knows I think that. So we're just stuck here trying to make the best of things.
This is the best of things. Children dying of diseases.
No. This is awful.
Where is this wagon? Where can we find it?
I can show you. It's supposed to be heading to a pediatric coming up through Valentine, but it's been diverted south instead.
Come on, Captain Monroe.
Mr. Morgan, we must act with due caution.
Oh, we shall. We surely shall. Now come.
Okay. I think I know a spot where we should be able to intercept it.
Lead the way, Captain. Good girl. So, this Colonel Favor, he knows you're up here helping these people?
Yes. And no. He knows I'm here to produce a report on the situation. I was sent down from the north after all the news of unrest in the region. But I think my presence might be making things worse.
What do you mean?
I worry he's taking some of these actions more to protect himself now. If he can incite more retaliation, maybe he can prove a stronger defense.
Well, like destroying that shrine.
Yes, and taking their horses. I mean, I don't know if he personally sanctioned any of this or not. This is the other problem. There's a culture now in his regiment. The rot has traveled down the trunk.
Okay. Well, just show me where to find this wagon, and I'll get the medicine for you. You don't need to be involved.
Thank you, Mr. Morgan. But I must ask you, please be discreet. We really cannot afford more conflict. I'm still hoping a meeting can be arranged between Rains Falls and Colonel Favors.
I understand. So I should drop the wagon back at the reservation?
Oh, no. No, no, no. You only need to commandeer the vaccine. Stealing those and an army wagon will only make matters much worse.
Okay.
You know, Favors has many flaws, but I don't believe he's callous. More an insecure man at the end of his career trying to cling on to something that's already gone. He fought for the Union in the war, and his record was considered far from illustrious. A failed man is often the most dangerous. I was thinking of. Let's cut up this way.
Sure.
There's a nice vantage point up at the top here. Okay, let's dismount here. Best leave the horses back a bit. We'll have a good view over the road from this ledge. The wagon should come along this way.
Okay.
You're a good man, Mr. Morgan, but I fear this task to be a fool's errand.
Well, firstly, I'm a long way from a good man. Secondly, fool's errands are my favorite kind of work.
Fair enough. In that case, I can see we shall be great friends.
May I ask you a question?
Of course.
Why don't you just tell all the folk up in Washington what kind of an idiot Colonel Favors is and save us all a lot of bother?
Unfortunately, the government doesn't work quite like that.
If you say so.
There. I think that's the wagon.
All right. Get yourself out of here.
Just remember to keep it clean, understand me?
Don't worry, I'm as clean as they come. All I do is clean.
Well, good luck.
I'll meet you back at the reservation.
Try not to get yourself killed, Mr. Morgan.
Well, now, I can't promise.
Thank you. hold still, girl.
Hello. Here I am, as promised.
Captain Monroe.
Of course.
Chief's gone out trying to find medications. It's quite a business.
Yes. Thought we were through with them.
Okay. I think I know a spot where we should be able to intercept it.
Lead the way, Captain. So, this Colonel Fate, he knows you're up here helping these people?
Yes. And no. He knows I'm here to produce a report on the situation. I was sent down from the north after all the news of unrest in the region. But I think my presence might be making things worse.
What do you mean?
I worry he's taking some of these actions more to protect himself now. He can incite more retaliation, maybe he can prove a stronger defense.
I like destroying that shrine.
Yes, and taking their horses. I mean, I don't know if he personally sanctioned any of this or not. This is the other problem. There's a culture now in his regiment. The rot has traveled down the trunk.
Okay. Well, just show me where to find this wagon, and I'll get the medicine for it. You don't need to be involved.
Thank you, Mr. Morton. But I must ask you, please be discreet. We really cannot afford more conflict. Still hoping a meeting can be arranged between Rains Falls and Colonel Favors.
I understand. So I should drop the wagon back at the reservation?
Oh, no. No, no, no. You only need to commandeer the backseat. Stealing those and an army wagon will only make matters much worse.
Okay.
You know, Favors has many flaws, but I don't believe he's callous. More an insecure man at the end of his career trying to cling on to something that's already gone. He fought for the Union in the war, and his record was considered far from illustrious. A failed man is often the most dangerous. All right. This is the spot I was thinking of. Let's cut up this way.
Sure.
There's a nice vantage point up at the top here. Dismount here. Best leave the horses back a bit. We'll have a good view over the road from this ledge. The wagon should come along this way.
Yeah. Captain Monroe? I got the medicine.
Ah, wonderful. That's great news, Mr. Morgan.
Yeah, well, don't worry. It didn't go too bad.
Oh, I'll have to take your word for that. We could both swing for this.
Yeah, well, I think I'm a little past caring about hanging, Monroe.
Maybe. I just hope Colonel Favors thinks he was robbed by bandits and not...
Oh, no, I'm still a bandit. There ain't no doubt about that.
Of course. Well, I better get to work. Thank you, Mr. Morgan. Bandit or not, this was a good thing. Maybe it'll get us both killed, but it had to be done.
I hope so.
rigors of simplicity take their toll on a woman.
Oh, I didn't mean
no,
it.
No, I know. Things are going well. I couldn't have done it without you.
You did it all yourself.
So how are you holding up?
I'm still standing. Which is an improvement on the last time you saw me.
I wish that there was something else that I could do.
Man, you have done more than enough.
Please, call me Sean.
Arthur. Arthur Morgan.
Well, you take care of yourself. Please, go on in and help yourself to anything you need. What's mine is yours.
Oh. Well, that's very kind.
Okay, take it easy. Yes, folks is gonna make a choice. Whether they live or die.
And you?
I don't have that choice no more. I'm just trying to help others see clearly. That's my choice.
You're a good man, Arthur Morgan. Good man.
Leaving again?
Yes, just leaving. I'll see you soon.
Perhaps.
What do you mean?
Well, if I was you, I'd disappear too. This is all pretty much over.
Well, I'll be back.
No, you won't. Let's not pretend no more. Get out of here.
I'll miss you, Arthur. You've been a fine friend to me.
Well, let's not get over sentimental. Well, the place is quiet. Get out of here. You go with my blessing.
Thank you, Arthur.
Found a friend looking for you.
Mr. Morgan.
Sir.
How are you?
A little better.
I hope so.
How can I help you?
I am sorry to impose on you again, but I believe I've made progress brokering peace.
You have?
I believe so. Colonel Favors has agreed to a meeting to discuss and maybe resolve his alleged grievances and mine. Now, he has lied to me more times than I care to remember, but maybe this time he must want peace. Why could he possibly want to humiliate us further?
We got words for his kind, but they're colloquial.
Perhaps I could make one last request. My men are not allowed to carry arms.
You want us to keep the peace?
Yeah, it'll be a lot of dull talking and ceremony. But I feel with some non-tribe members present, their chances of lying or worse will be reduced.
Will you, Arthur?
It ain't my business, brother.
No, I know. But it is mine. Do it for me.
Charles, I got...
I've saved your life. Do it for me.
Sure. Come on. You owe this man.
You should have him do your negotiations.
Let's go.
Thank you for doing this, both of you. You have already done so much.
Ain't a problem. Just hope nobody recognizes me. I've had a few run-ins with the army recently.
I wish we could have done more to control the situation.
Dutch should not have gotten involved.
My son has a mind of his own. Too much so, in fact. Just hope Colonel Favor can be reasoned with. I am not asking for very much, but when our people are sick and hungry, and we find our medicine and supplies are being deliberately withheld, how can we not view that as something personal? When they destroy our sacred sites, how can I convince Eagle Flies and the others that they shouldn't fight back?
Maybe that's part of the reason they're doing these things. Because they want you to fight. Be able to say, look, you see how these savages behave?
Perhaps. Thank you for helping Captain Monroe to retrieve those vaccines, Arthur. He will be at the meeting and is one person who knows the true situation, at least. I still have hope that we can come to an agreement. Ahead.
Hello.
Whoa.
Whoa.
We chasha kilana, kula which yampi, hiopo, unyapi ktelo. This way.
Colonel Favors, Captain Monroe, we come in peace.
Hello again. Who are these two?
They're friends of my people.
Hmm. Interesting looking fellows.
Yeah, they won't cause any trouble.
Well, I should hope not.
Yeah.
Listen, Mr.
Chief.
Yes, Mr. I can't say that silly name.
In English, they call me Rainsfall.
Yes, yes, I'm sure they do. Listen, we're all Americans here, and we want an outcome. But quite frankly, I'm confused. Your men are little more than criminals, in my opinion.
Keep breaking peace treaties we've made, causing disturbances in everybody's lives. But I pride myself on being a gentleman. Really, I do. But there are limits. So, let me be very... You okay, man? Someone. Jackson, take him away. Where was I?
You're a gentleman with limits?
Are you being facetious, sir?
Come this way, buddy.
I said, are you being facetious, Captain Monroe?
No, sir, I am not.
Chief Raines.
That's, Raines' fault.
Exactly. Chief Raines, the thing
is... It's quite
is,
a cough.
Federal government.
Sure.
Wait here. Situation. I'll fetch you some water.
I'll be fine. Thank you.
No, no. You know he's going to have Monroe court-martialed. Or attempt to. He's going to make a disgrace of him.
Monroe? He seems likable enough for a West Pointer. Why?
You know what Favors is like. Because he thinks it's right. Because he thinks Monroe is a patsy. Or a spy. He's convinced he had something to do with those vaccines getting stolen. He thinks Monroe is gonna force him into making a concession with the Indians. So he removes Monroe.
Removes how?
Favors wants him tried for treason and hanged.
Why does Favors care about the Indians?
Because he doesn't want to back down. His whole professional life. You know what they say about him. Hightail Favors. The man who missed a battle.
Poor Monroe. Kind of liked him.
I know. Well, still, he's kind of stuck up.
Your men violated the treaty. That treaty is null and void. I have been appointed to negotiate...
Feeling better?
Yeah. Come on. Let's go.
The lands you currently occupy belong to the United States government. Why is this so confusing, sir? Why?
Good day, Colonel Favors.
Well, that was remarkably unproductive.
So?
I'm afraid the federal government was quite clear, Colonel, that it wanted peace, and peace for all, and that the treaty had not been broken by anybody.
Oh, is that so, sir? And did it want impudence, sir, from a junior officer in public? Was that its plan too, sir? You insult me. You insult the regiment. Arrest this man.
Arrest me?
Gross insubordination. Disobeying an order. Treason.
Are you mad?
You had those vaccines stolen. You disrupted a negotiation.
Let him go.
This is all getting out of hand.
Hi.
Captain Monroe, let's get out of here.
If I
were you, I'd keep my mouth shut, amigo. I don't want to kill this man, but shall.
Bitch.
Charles, Captain Monroe, mount up now. We're getting out of here.
I got a shot.
You won't get away with this.
Open fire!
Follow me!
On our tail.
You're a dead man now. I can't shoot at these men.
Yeah, but we
What do we do now?
You get out of here. Fast. Take you to the station.
I can't believe that just happened. I've been an army man my whole life.
I heard them talking. They was gonna have you hanged for treason. We can't die for those fools.
And what about the chief?
We'll do what we can.
I guess I won't be submitting my report.
I wouldn't think so. Hold. Here, Captain Monroe.
I fear it may be Mr. Monroe from now on.
I'm sorry about your career. Here. Here's some money. You take it and get out of here and start a new life somewhere. I hear Tahiti's nice.
Thank you.
Just hop on a train to San Denis, jump on a boat, but avoid Guam.
Where?
Forget about it.
Meet you back at camp.
Mr. Morgan! Are you okay?
Yeah. Never better. What are you doing here?
Well, I'm on my way down to Mexico. They're finally sending me on a mission. Brother Dorkins is very jealous. What's wrong?
I'm dying, sister.
Okay.
Yeah, I got TB. I got it. Beating a man to death for a few bucks. I've lived a bad life, sister.
We've all lived bad lives, Mr. Morgan. We all sin. But I know you.
You don't know me.
Forgive me, but that's the problem. You don't know you.
What do you mean?
I don't know, but whenever we happen to meet, you're always helping people and smiling.
I had a son. He passed away. I had a girl who loved me. I threw that away. My mama died when I was a kid. And my daddy, well, I watched him die. And it weren't soon enough.
My husband died a long time ago. Life is full of pain. But there is also love and beauty.
What am I gonna do now?
Be grateful that for the first time, you see your life clearly.
Sure.
Perhaps you could help somebody. Helping makes you really happy.
But I still don't believe in nothing.
Often, neither do I. But then I meet someone like you. And everything makes sense.
You're too smart for me, sister. I guess I'm afraid.
There is nothing to be afraid of, Mr. Morgan. Take a gamble that love exists and do a loving act.
All aboard!
I shall try.
I know you will. Goodbye, Mr. Morgan. Goodbye.
Sister?
come.
There you are.
Here I am.
Come on, let's go.
Let's go where? And why are you so riled up?
Today is a great day, Arthur. Today is the day they are going to hang Colm O'Driscoll.
That's so.
Rather they hang him or I shoot him.
Oh, they are gonna hang him.
Yeah, and not before time.
That boy's been on the gallows more than most. I wouldn't count anything until his neck's broke.
Well, nor would I. Which is why, despite us being wanted men, we're gonna attend the event ourselves.
And follow him onto the scaffold?
Well, let's hope not. But if I could see that son of a bitch breathe his last, I think I'd die a happy man. We are gonna disguise ourselves.
In this?
In this.
Okay.
Come on.
Well, don't we just look the part?
We'll cut through the alley to get to the gallows. We keep our weapons holstered, our disguises on, and our wits about us.
Mrs. Adler, might I say, being a fancy woman of Saint Denis suits you.
I'd dress up like the Queen of Sheba if it meant seeing that son of a bitch swing.
Colm hung me up, nearly butchered me. That don't mean I'm comfortable in this woolen coat.
You made it out of that predicament, as I remember, Mr. Morgan. My husband weren't so lucky.
You lost your husband. I lost my darling Annabelle. That poor boy Kieran. We've all lost something because of Colm. And that is why we will shepherd him to eternity.
Amen to that.
Keep those fingers off those triggers, because we'll need cool heads and calm dispositions to see this done.
Practice what you preach, brother.
Whatever do you mean?
Are you gonna keep your cool? Really? When you seem to lose it all so often now.
This doubting and questioning of yours? I miss the old Arthur.
Don't we all?
You two quit it. We all got a job to do. We're all in rough agreement about how we're doing it, as far as I can tell.
Exactly.
We'll get it done, all right.
All right, then. Come on. We got a hanging to witness.
Look here. Don't the public love an execution? See that pair of assholes?
Sure.
They're Colm's boys.
Yes, I think so.
What a surprise. I'm glad we're here. What are they pointing at?
I don't know. We gotta follow them and find out.
Yeah. Oh, here comes somebody. Stay here.
Don't do nothing.
Go brush that horse, officer.
Yes, sir.
The crowd came to see a show. We don't want to disappoint them.
I guess they did miss their chance to see John swing by his neck.
Hey, hey. You know I wasn't going to let it come to that.
Well, I guess I don't know what I know no more.
And I guess this isn't the time to question either my decisions or yours. Here and now, Colm O'Driscoll's going to get his due. He's cutting in there. Let's go. Quiet.
What's it look like? Bunch of cops. So what do you think?
Paul's up on the roof. Once he starts shooting, we have to have our wits about us and move fast.
Yeah, I guess we faced worse than this before.
Sure. Let's get to it.
Yeah.
So,
They got a guy up on the roof, overlooking the gallows. Find a way up there, onto one of these verandas, through a building maybe, and get him. And do it silently.
Well, obviously I'm gonna do it silently. I wanna see this bastard swing.
Just shoot her then.
Find a way up to the roof and stop him. I'll go back to the tablet.
To deal with him justly is by savagery. Colm O'Driscoll is one such man. He has murdered, tortured, robbed, stolen, raped, and abused for a decade across five states, seemingly with impunity. Today, justice catches up with him.
As well you may. I've been a bad man.
Silence!
These charges...
This is not a court where you shall be tried. This is a place where your sentence is to be carried out. And your sentence, Colm O'Driscoll, is that you are to be hanged by the neck until you are dead. This is not a task we take lightly. It is not a task we enjoy, but it is a task we must carry out if our civilization is to prosper. Gentlemen, are we ready? Colm O'Driscoll, may God, in his infinite wisdom, have mercy upon your soul. Whenever you are ready.
Now you know how it feels to watch somebody you love die. You ruined my life! Die! Die! Die!
Morgan! You hear us? Take a shot on these O'Driscolls!
Thank you.
take it on, Arthur?
Well, we saw the bastard hang okay, but the whole thing ain't gonna save us.
I guess that's one less thing to worry about.
I guess, compared to the entire government, in the end, Como Driscoll didn't seem like such a worry.
A letter came for you.
Oh, okay.
I know it's from that Mary.
Mary?
She ain't worth it, Arthur.
Who is?
My dear Arthur, you never showed up. And now, after looking at the newspapers, I understand why. I don't imagine you'll receive this letter, but I, nonetheless, must send it. Arthur. Oh, Arthur. I was just starting to dream the silliest and softest of dreams. I miss you, and I will always miss you. But I cannot live like that. And it seems you cannot live any other way. When I'm with you, the world makes sense, but when we are apart, I see clearly that your world is not a world from which one can escape. I'm so sorry for everything. For everything long ago, and for starting up that business again. There's a good man within you, Arthur, but he is wrestling with a giant. And the giant.
Hey, Arthur.
You okay, friend?
Never better.
Dutch. You're breaking his heart. You know that.
Did he tell you to say this to me, friend?
No.
Come on, sit.
The Reverend left, Arthur.
Where'd he go?
I don't know. He left me a note. Told me I should do the same.
Why?
Well, I think he's worried.
He's a right to be worried. You worried?
Sure, but I still think maybe things will turn out okay. You'll steer Dutch right. I know you will.
I'll try, Miss Grimshaw. Really, I will.
Morning, Arthur.
You okay, Jack?
Is Mr. Strauss gone?
Yeah, he had to leave. Sorry.